गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो आई लक्षणा कौशिक वेलकम यू ऑल इन द फिजिक्स क्लास. सो नाउ वी हैव जस्ट रीच्ड द लास्ट टॉपिक ऑफ दिस चैप्टर, दैट इज वेन डी ग्राफ जनरेटर. सो वेन डी ग्राफ जनरेटर इज बेसिकली इज अ जनरेटर. वी कैन सी द जनरेटर विच जनरेट द चार्जेस. येस, द चार्जेस आर जनरेटेड ओवर हियर. सो दिस इज बेसिकली अ जनरेटर विच इज हैविंग अ पोटेंशियल टू बिल्ड अ potential difference of larger amount. This is a machine that can build up high potential difference of the order of a few million volts. So it is an electrostatic machine designed in 1913 by Robert J. Van de Graaff. That is why it is known as Van de Graaff generator. He developed it further with his associate John G. Trump. It produces high voltage of order 10 million volt, which is used to accelerate charge particles. So charge particles can be accelerated by the use of this Van de Graaff generator. Now this Van de Graaff generator works on the principle of discharging action of sharp point. Yes, so discharging action of sharp point is known as corona discharge. Discharging action of this sharp point is known as corona discharge. Okay, now you can see that nowadays corona is going on. So today is the latest and biggest news is about the corona. So corona, basically it means the crown, the shape of a crown, and here we are in physics, the meaning of corona is discharging. Basically we can connect it with our diseases also. It discharges the virus from one body to another. It is communicable disease. Yes, so it is a discharging action of this charges is known as corona discharge. So discharging action of sharp point, corona discharge at the potential end of a conductor in air. So let us have a look at this Van de Graaff generator. So this is our Van de Graaff generator. You can see this is a shell where all the charges are distributed, and there is a comb. Here you can see these are sharp ends of a comb, C1 and C2. Yes. So S is a large spherical metallic globe. This S, you can see it is a large metallic spherical globe which is mounted on spherical pillars, which is mounted on actually insulating pillars P1 and P2. So these pillars are insulating, means they are not conducting, but these is a metallic sphere. Got it? And they are non-conducting insulators. Now R1 and R2 are two rollers. They are two rollers. And on these two rollers, one belt is there, which are driven with the help of an electric motor, a conveyor belt AB. This is AB belt, yes, of some insulating material runs over these rollers at a speed of about 60 mile per hour. And this C1 and C2, you can see here, these C1 and C2 are two metal combs. You can see here are metallic combs over here. You can see metallic combs. If you can see, if I'm able to zoom it, it is C1 and it is C2. So these are two metallic combs, each having over 100 teeth. You have seen the comb, but it is metallic. They have over 100 teeth, and these combs are arranged close to the belt. The lower comb C1, this lower comb C1 is connected to positive charge. Yes. And of DC generator, which provides a voltage of 10 kV to 50 kV, and the upper comb C2 is connected to globe. This C2 is connected to globe, and this C1 is connected to the positive terminal, and they give a DC generator. Now how it works, let us see. Now let us study about its working. Due to high density of positive charge, you can see the C1 is at positive charge at the sharp points due to the teeth C1. Positive charge is sprayed on the belt. You can see there we are giving positive charge. So positive charge, due to its sharp end, the positive charge in the comb, by the comb, is sprayed to the belt. Yes, and the positive charge is continuously sprayed, carried by the belt to the top. Now positive charge is carried to the belt by the bell to the top due to electrostatic induction at the comb C2. You know induction, positive will get negative and negative will become positive. Yes, the globe gets positively charged and the teeth of C2 gets negatively charged. This C2 will get negatively charged. The positive charge of the belt get neutralized by negative charge on the teeth. Thus, the globe continuously gets positive charge. This globe, this one, this bigger globe gets positively charged with respect to Earth, goes on rising. If at any instant the charge on the globe, is CQ, okay, then what will be its potential? V is equals to Q upon C. It will be its potential. When the globe is charged to a very high potential, it is unable to hold a charge. Yes, it will happen. If it is charged at a very high voltage, then it will not be able to hold the charge. Yes, and sometime due to the high amount of potential, the sparking and leakage takes place. The generator is therefore enclosed in a steel chamber. There is a steel chamber, that is why it is enclosed in a steel chamber with nitrogen or sulfur hexafluoride, and this prevents sparking and leakage of charge. Yes, now question comes where it is used. It is used to separate electric charges and build them frequently for demonstration purpose. Yes, so this is all about Venn diagram generator. So this is the last topic of your. Now after Venn diagram generator, there comes a topic known as dielectric strength. So what is this dielectric strength? You know, dielectric is a medium which is just filled between the plates of a capacitor and it is an insulating material. Yes, it does not allow charges to flow from this point to this point. So it is known as dielectric. Now what is dielectric strength? It is the maximum electric field that can exist in a dielectric without causing the breakdown of its insulating property. So it is a maximum electric field. We provide a maximum electric field that can exist in a dielectric without causing the breakdown of its insulating property. It is a maximum electric field that can exist in a dielectric without causing it the breakdown of its insulating property. So it is called dielectric strength and its SI unit is volt per meter. Can also be written as this. Yes. Now capacitance of a parallel plate with dielectric slab of thickness T is given by capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor with dielectric slab and its thickness is T. So it is given by C is equals to epsilon naught A D minus T 1 minus 1 upon K. Now again the capacitance, this was with dielectric slab. Now if this dielectric slab is just replaced by conducting slab, so capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor with conducting slab of thickness T. So what will be the capacitance? Epsilon naught A D minus T. Yes. So now how we can define dielectric constant? Now dielectric constant is the ratio of capacitance with dielectric between plates and capacitance with vacuum between plates. So numerically it will be equal to K is equals to C upon C naught. So this is the last topic, and in the next class we'll be discussing notes and even some numericals. Thank you.